Hi, so Tom wants me to show how I make my homemade chicken and noodles, or you can use turkey, which we're doing. Take the meat off of the bone, and so you can have roast turkey or roast chicken the day before with mashed potatoes and gravy and whatever, and the next day you make chicken and noodle soup. Now you want to dice just a little bit of carrots, celery, and onions. Get them really small. It gives it good flavor, a good broth, and that's what we're doing. Okay, so these are all prepared ahead of time. Now we're going to work on the noodles. Now here is where you can't buy these. I've put 3 eggs in the bowl. It depends on how many noodles you want. 3 eggs will give you a pretty good chicken noodle soup. A whole pot like that. Oops. Okay. I like just to put a dash of Lowry's. It's my go-to. I use it for everything. Black pepper, freshly cracked. A little bit of garlic powder. I don't use garlic salt because it's just salt. I like garlic powder. It's garlic. Then we keep the vampires away. Oh my. Now we're going to put in a dash of kosher salt. So maybe it's a kosher recipe now. All right, here we go. Now this comes the hard part, and I might incorporate Kristen because I might need to get more. You don't have to talk, Kristen. You might just have to.
I'm not even here.
Yeah, I think that you are, and I think you're going to stir.
No,
stir, honey girl. I got to get more flour. Yep, stir it.
Whip She's it. So good.
Whip
this
it really good. It. Whip it. Whip it into
Whip
shape.
It. Whip it good.
But you want to get your flour down so it doesn't, you know what I mean? Now the tricky part is coming up. Once we get this incorporated into the liquid, then we're going to be putting more in. So here we are at this kind of state. Now you can see it needs a little more flour. So you kind of, right now, just put a little in.
How do you know it needs more flour?
Because it was too sticky. You can't roll this out. You can't roll this out if it's that sticky, you know?
Okay.
You're just going to have a big fat mess.
How do you know when it's done?
I don't know.
That's you!
$16 million. Well, you'll see. You're
really
seeing it
really
in video. Okay, so see how it's not so sticking to the fork?
Yes.
That's a good sign. I think I'm ready to put it out. Now, my trick is to use wax paper because I don't like scrubbing a table when I'm done. So this right here is going to save me a lot of time.
That's awesome.
I tell you what, it makes me feel lazy, but I like it. And you sprinkle a little flour. We're going to dump it out. Oh, we forgot to put wheat germ. I usually incorporate a little wheat germ in it just to give us, you know, the benefits of having wheat germ and nobody knows they're eating it. Nobody knows they're getting that benefit, but, well, this is a new deal to me. And if we have to do it again next time, Tom's going to deal. Because we're free Americans for just a little bit longer. Never know how long. Gotta get out there and vote.
Crap. Did you vote?
Don't have anybody to vote for. Okay, so now you flour the top as well as the bottom. And then you do this, and then you don't have to scrub your wooden.
Mm-hmm.
And Carrie went on a mission to Mexico, and this is what she brought back.
Oh, that's cool.
And I like to flour it just a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're rolling. Yeah, I don't think I'll need any more. That's see how sticky it is? This is where you kind of come into a conundrum. There. It's a good thing just to stop and do that.
That's good, though.
So that you can dry out these too wet. This is too wet. That's the problem there. We're going to put where it looks wet at, that's where we put more. See, that's plenty. That's got plenty.
Perfect.
But then you want to let this dry for half hour, hour. They're going to sit and dry, and then we cut. And all this flour that's around, you're not going to waste it. It will go into the pot at the end to thicken the your broth.
So, yeah,
so we're not wasting any of this flour that's around here. I like them to be pretty thin. But you can make them as fat or as thin, as long as or as short as you like your noodles. Now it's just going to hang out for about an hour. Okay, we've let our dough rest here. Half an hour it needs, but we've had it about an hour and a half. So it's not a big deal about that. So we're going to let it rest some more while we come over here. We're going to saute our onions, carrots, and celery. This gives our broth a really good base. I hear the sizzling, so that sounds good. Make sure you wash your hands before you start cooking. That's to you, Ellie girl. We're just sauteing them. Be generous with olive oil because it's the good fat. Your body needs that. Not trans fats. That's bad for your body. But olive oil is, and avocado is rich with fats that are good for your body. So you just have to be careful of the fats you put in your body. That's going to take a while. So while that's doing that, we're going to start cutting our noodles. Which, we're not going to film this whole part because it takes a long time. I'll show you the start and then we're going to take a break. You just go like this and you can cut them as fat or as wide as you want or skinny. Can you see it all right, Tom? You're just cutting them the length of the noodles you want. Now, maybe you like them really skinny, and you can go like that. It's totally up to you. We put the garlic powder and the Lowry's in the noodles, and I kind of like to put it on my vegetables. This is just my recipe. People are different.
How long do you let it?
Just saute it.
How long do you let it saute?
You'll know when they get soft. Then we put in the chicken broth, and then I use water and chicken bouillon. But I usually don't have this, but I have a can. I'm going to use it. So, but I think chicken bouillon you can add more because you put a little bit in and taste it, and then if it's not, if the broth isn't chickeny enough, you put a little more in. So it's everybody's taste. Okay, now I wouldn't cut them this way because I like my noodles long, but Tom wants his short. So you can do it any way you like. Now we're going to go over here because our vegetables have sautéed very beautifully. And we're just going to pour in some water. We're going to get a broth going. And I don't do measurements. I just do. I'm getting some chicken bouillon.
Oh, that's weird.
And I do this to flavor. So I just kind of get started. I'm adding chicken broth, but I have water and chicken bouillon. But I just want to get enough. Because we're going to add a bunch of meat. And Tom cut the meat up. So we're getting ready to put that in. You have to bring this to a rolling boil before you start putting your noodles in.
You put the meat in first?
Mm-hmm. You want to get the flavors all incorporated. Okay, so you can cut your chicken or turkey chunks up into whatever size you like. And we are taking the noodles off of the wax paper and getting ready to put it in the water. You have to bring it to a rolling boil. You have to bring it to a rolling boil. Come on over here. Tom's being a bit annoying. We're rolling with it. Okay, this is quite a bit, and I might have to add more liquid.
We did a full plate before that.
It's pretty full here. So we want this to incorporate the flavors and just let it keep boiling while we take a break and finish cutting up the noodles.
Yay!
We have our egg noodles all cut up and ready to go in. You want to have a rolling boil. See that rolling boil? Because if it isn't rolling like that, then they stick like a glob of glue. You don't want that. You want it to be really hot, and you just kind of stir it as you put them in. Now, since we took the lid off, it stopped the rolling boil, but you can see it's coming back. Smells really good. And just continue to do this until your noodles are all in there. Then you can let it simmer. Turn it down and let it simmer for about, I'd say at least an hour, but you always have to come and stir it. But it, like I said, if people are starving,
someone's got the last
20 minutes you can probably feed them. I always think it's better the next day, personally. Let the flavors incorporate. And now we're over and out. Signing out.